I hope you all keeping well, and you have a poem to study. That is a spring poem titled Spring. So before studying this poem, let's learn who wrote this poem. So it is written by Perla Pushkin. The poem was written by Perla Pushkin. She was an author, poet, illustrator, and a reviewer of children's books. So she was also well known for her poetic musical style. She was well known for her style, that is a poetic style and a musical style. And she illustrated nearly half of the books she wrote. She herself illustrated her half of the books she had written. So she had written many poems, and from her many books she almost illustrated near half of her books. And let's learn about the spring, the poem. In this poem, it is telling about the central idea of the poem. Spring is welcoming the spring. So the central idea of the poem Spring is welcoming the spring. So the poet, the speaker is welcoming the spring. So we are also have a spring season. So how can we able to welcome that spring season? So here the speaker is welcoming the spring. So the speaker welcomes the lovely weather through words that denote. So here the speaker is welcoming the spring. How? Through the words denotes color, beauty, and eagerness. Today let's learn a poem written by Perla Pushkin. So this poem we can see it is a whole about spring season. Here a girl or the speaker herself welcomes the season of spring and after a long time of winter. As we know that spring season comes just after the winter season. So in this poem we will be seeing many words the speaker uses, which gives us an enthusiasm and a strong feeling of spring season. So let's move to this first stanza. I'm shouting, I'm singing, I'm swinging through trees, I'm winging sky high with the buzzing black bees. In this poem, the speaker is shouting, singing, swinging through trees, and the girl is excited about on the first day of the spring season. And we can see that the girl is excited as if she is flying along with the bees. So this is what we can see in this first stanza. So let's go to the second stanza. I'm the sun, I'm the moon, I'm the dew on the rose, I'm a rabbit whose habit is switching his nose. So in this stanza we can see the girl is girl's closeness of nature. Here the girl becomes one of the nature. She becomes one part of the nature in this stanza by saying, I am the sun, I am the moon, I am the dew on the rose, I am the rabbit. Through these words, we can see the closeness of this girl to the nature. And here, the poet or the speaker uses the metaphor. What is metaphor? Metaphor is when two unlike things are compared, being treated as one. Metaphor is when two unlike things. What is the two unlike things here? One thing is the girl, and another thing is the objects of nature, such as the sun, the moon, and the dew, and the rabbit. So these are the objects of nature. So here, two unlike things, that is the girl and as well as the objects of nature are compared, and these things are compared. Girl is compared with the sun, moon, rose, and dew rose, and also the rabbit. And it is treated as one. So when it is treated as one, so it is known as a metaphor. It is a usage of in English. So here we can see the oneness of the poet, or oneness of this girl, or the closeness of a girl to the nature. So, third stanza. I'm lovely, I'm kicking my heels, I'm crying, come dance to the fresh water eels. Here we can see the feelings of the girl. The speaker describes the feeling of the girl, that is she is what? She is lively, and she is lively, and also she likes to do whatever makes her to happy. So she just move around and just kicking her heels. And she also, the next stanza, I'm crying, come dance to the fresh water. Here it shows the eagerness and enthusiasm of the girl by seeing the spring season. So here she asks the fresh water to dance with her. So let's continue, and the fourth and the final stanza. I'm racing through meadows without any coat. I'm a gamboling lamb. I'm a light leaping goat. I'm a bat. I'm a blue. I'm a dove on the wing. I'm running on the rooftops and welcoming spring. And here in this stanza we can see that she just running through the meadows, the grasses, and without any coat, without her warm coat, which signifies, which shows that the end of the winter and the beginning of the spring, so that she moved or she was running through the meadows without the warm coat. there is a lake and she also chatting, she is just like a pot. There is a, she just moving around, running just like a lamb. And a bat, a moon, a dove on the wing, I'm running on the rooftops and welcoming spring. All these lines shows that she is welcoming and enjoying the season, the beautiful season of spring. So these lines signifies the end of the winter season and the beginning of the spring season. So here these lines signifies us the end of the winter and the beginning of a spring season. So this is the poem. We can understand the meaning of this poem. All of you please go through your textbook and learn the poem. So this is